In the last few years, I've noticed a trend amongst the ADV community, both online and offline. Dialogue, tropes, and ideas that are constantly rehashed, and I think are pretty problematic. Dialogue where everyone has an opinion, expresses that opinion loudly, and tells other people how to behave. In this sea of repetitive comments where people are telling other people that bikes like this V-Strom 800 can't go off-road, that the only option is to ride an ever-increasingly small bike, or that the riding being done on adventure bikes isn't even off-road.
But lighter and smaller isn't always better. Unlike most things on the internet, I think there's a ton of nuance to this. Let me explain.
In 2023, I made two videos on the Trans-Euro Trail in northern Spain, and something stood out. I saw a good amount of people riding their bikes on the trails, and it was really cool. GasGas ES700s, KTM 450s and 500s, and only four adventure bikes. The bikes me and my friends were riding.
It was a surprise. Adventure bikes are the biggest selling bikes on the market. They are the bike of the moment. The entire motorcycle industry is frothing over them. And yet here we were, adventure riding in northern Spain, and the only adventure bikes we saw were on the street, and the only bikes we saw in the adventure trails were dirt bikes.
Those enduro-style bikes are lighter, more off-road focused, fast, lots of suspension, no wind protection, uncomfortable, and they need a lot more maintenance. The pros and cons of these bikes are mostly obvious. Mostly. The community of adventure riding that is regularly embracing more capable off-road adventure bikes has grown dramatically in the last 10 years. The KTM 690 platform has a cult following. Adventure Spec have built their brand around riding small, light bikes, and rightly so. Heck, I even built a lightweight adventure for riding the UK's hardest trails, and it was great.
Where this becomes interesting is in the dogma. Wherever you find an idea forms, you will find zealots. You can see this in play across the entire world, the internet, wherever you look.
My earliest memory of haters and naysayers in the motorcycle community was, well, you guessed it was a long way round. It wasn't real because their mates came in a car to film it. It was stupid to ride GSs. They didn't know what they were doing. Austin Vince, Ted Simon, et al. Did it first, better, cooler, the right way. But I recently rewatched Long Way Round, and it was incredible.
It was balls. Cow balls, sheep balls, and goat balls, and there were 200.
Sure, they made dumb decisions, but they were normal, inexperienced people having a go at something really quite extreme, and I think they only deserve to be celebrated for that.
I see this semi-regularly on my own videos. People telling me that I'm not going off-road on my adventure bike, that a Cadillac or a transit van or a scooter could be doing what I'm doing, that big bikes can't go off-road. Now, doesn't take me to tell you why that's probably not the smartest thing that's ever been written in a YouTube comment. Now, I'm not going to absolve myself of guilt here. I have been guilty of exactly the same thing about other types of motorcycling, saying stupid things about Harleys and other poorly formed opinions.
But here, in adventure bikes, it is different from tribalistic jokes in jest. It's almost like they've never seen a Chris Birch, Killian Mirabay, or Paul Tarez video. And I can see them writing the response now. Those guys are pros. They can do it on anything. Except the sticking point here is that I'm not a pro, and neither are any of my friends that I ride with. Some of us are decent. Some of us have put in time to get skillful and are better than decent. But I promise you that Chris Birch rides rings around me and all my mates.
He won't know this, but he has. He rode past me on a downhill in Romaniacs that I could barely ride. The zealotry is in promoting a false truth, fake news, imparting your truth on someone else as gospel.
The problem here is not the bike. Technology in bikes has never really been better. As much as KTM 990 lovers want to tell you, bikes are better now. I've tested them. Old school bikes are cool, but for the most part, modern adventure bikes are insanely capable at everything, and the improvements are huge. That's partly the reason we have this continuing boom. The BMW GS is a great adventure bike. It can do a ton of difficult things. The KTM 890R is outrageously good off-road.
This V-Strom 800 is already a grossly misunderstood bike. I think it's a great bike if it's used how it was intended, for adventure riding.
The problem is not the bike, and the narrative around the subject misses something key. Taking responsibility for your skill level. Your skill level is the problem, and that is okay. No one is expecting you to be Tony Bow. You could give me a trials bike today, and I promise you I can't do much more on it than I can do on an enduro bike. Is the trials bike the problem? No.
I am shockingly bad at trials, but I also don't have the time on a trials bike to have become good at riding a trials bike.
Now, if the riding you want to do and the skill level you have won't let you take a V-Strom 800 DE up the hills, down the ruts, or across the rivers you want to ride, then hell, ride the bike that gives you confidence. I have enough skill that I'm comfy enough to get an adventure bike neatly to where I want to be. I can take a GS on most green lanes in the UK, I can ride some enduro on a well-prepped T7, and again, I'm not a pro-level rider, not even close, but I have some skill and I've practiced a lot.
And that's kind of part of the problem, is that the wider community assumes that to get to, say, my level, or anyone who is what you would consider above average, takes some bag of magic talent beans. But I don't think that's the case.
I spent more than a decade instructing with my folks at off-road skills, and the improvement you can make in your riding in a short time is nothing short of amazing. I'd love to put it down to my wonderful instructing abilities, but like anything in life, if you put in purposeful practice, you can make pretty big strides forward. The key, however, is not bike time, it's purposeful, considered practice, thinking about and improving your technique and using drills to do so.
So the problem here is not the bike, it's you and your skill level, and then matching your skill level to the riding that you want to do and the bike that's going to let you do that.
How do we figure that out? That is the magic question. There are four steps to choosing the right bike for you.
Step one is remembering the end goal of why you're doing this. Enjoyment. Pick the bike that you're going to enjoy the most. The one that when you open the garage door puts a smile on your face and gets you excited to do your hobby.
If the engine makes you giggle or it lets you go to the places you want, it's probably a good bike for you.
Next, we need a little moment of self-reflection.
Have you ridden a ton of enduro and gotten to being a good technical rider, able to ride feet up through most stuff and never really be too worried? Or are you a complete beginner off-road?
Or are you a competent trail rider who never does any skills practice or training? To do this, our ego needs to go in our back pocket. We need to have some reflection and some reality about where we are now and what we want to do now, not where we might be in a few years or what we've read on the internet.
Then we need to match your skills to the riding you want to do. If you love exploring, but only want to ride dirt roads, enjoy some street riding, and cover some distance, don't buy a dirt bike. They are awful on the road. Buy a V-Strom 800 DE, or something like that, an adventure touring bike. If you want to do more technical dirt roads, the occasional single track, or ride your adventure like an enduro bike, get something more off-road focused, a T7, a KTM 890 Adventure R, a Touareg 660. If you're really experienced and better than most off-road, you probably don't need to watch this video, and you can probably ride most bikes available. And if you want to ride terrain that makes you feel uncomfortable or is on the edge of your ability, get something you're in charge of as much as possible. A CRF 300L or a dirt bike if you really want to suffer on the road. I think this is one of the key questions. Can I be in charge of that bike in the terrain I'm planning to ride? Can I turn it around in a small Spanish village on the side of a hill? Can I ride a rut on it, pick it up, even if I need assistance, and not feel terrified of it? If you can, you're going to enjoy riding more than riding a bike that makes you feel uncomfortable.
That is the reason I don't ride small adventure bikes regularly. Riding thousands of kilometers on the road on a dirt bike, well, it sucks.
I rode a Dakar on a 450, and every one of those 10,000 kilometers on the street or the easy dirt road was shitty, and converting enduro bikes to adventure bikes comes with some serious compromises for me. It's why Lyndon Poskett built the ridiculously custom bike he did, a specific bike for his needs, skill levels, and choices. And now he's riding an adventure bike with extra good suspension and ripping on it and leading rally schools.
The right bike for him. I am in the position where, for the most part, I can take an adventure bike to where I want to, get it through most of the things that I come across, and more importantly, deal with it when I can't get through it.
On the plus side, they're great for actually covering distance on. Comfy, great on the street, they make getting to the good stuff easy, and when I'm riding gravel roads, it's as fun on these for me as it is on a dirt bike. On top of that, the next time someone writes a comment on ADV Rider, YouTube, or Facebook about adventure bikes not being able to do adventure riding, being glorified street bikes, or anything else like that, bin them.
Just bin them. They are an idiot.
The point here is that as a community, we could be more encouraging of people's choices. If you want to ride a V-Strom 800 around the world, do it. If you want to ride a C90 or an R1300 GS, do it. And if someone else has a different priority for enjoyment, support them. We're all here because it's fun, but being the person who lectures others in the pub or in the YouTube comments makes you a pretty unfun person to be around.